Welcome to another wildlife exploration. Today, we'll dive deep into the world of one of the most unique and fascinating predators in the ocean, the bull shark. Ever wondered why it's called bull, or how it adapts to both salt and fresh water? Stay tuned to unravel these mysteries and much more. There's no question that bull sharks are large fish. This is a shark that can stretch up to 13 feet, or around 4 meters, and tips the scales at approximately 1,100 pounds. That's about 500 kilograms. However, these are rather the extreme cases, and they are usually a bit shorter and lighter. When you compare it to the long and slender hammerhead, or the petite blacktip reef shark, the bull shark's sheer heft becomes evident. Bull sharks are one of the heavier predatory sharks. These aggressive sharks have a reputation with anglers as a powerful competitor for fish. Of course, such impressive mass comes with its unique set of demands. To maintain its bulk and vigorous energy levels, a bull shark's caloric intake is immense. When it comes to the bull shark's dining habits, there's a lot on the menu. Their appetite ranges from smaller fish and sharks to crustaceans, rays, and even seabirds on rare occasions. But they're happy taking larger prey too. A bull shark will feed on mammals, other sharks, and even turtles, and they are able to feast in such a flexible manner on account of their amazing teeth. The bull shark's mouth boasts around 50 rows of teeth in both its upper and lower jaws. At any one time, they'll have around 350 teeth in their mouth. But they don't keep these teeth for life. Much like a conveyor belt, as the front teeth break or fall out, the teeth from the back rows move forward, ensuring they're always equipped with a sharp set. These teeth are characterized by their broad bases and narrow, triangular upper portions. The broader base gives the tooth strength, while the pointed tip aids in piercing through the flesh of its prey. It's a combination of force and precision, a perfect multi-tool for a generalist predator. Despite its flexibility in diet, bull sharks live relatively short, solitary lives. It's thought that they last around 15 to 18 years in the wild, though one was said to have lived for 3 decades in captivity. In the wild, this short lifespan is compensated for by a diverse range of habitats. While most ocean creatures are confined to specific saltwater aquatic conditions, the bull shark routinely defies these norms. They don't just limit themselves to the warm salinity of the oceans, but also venture into fresh water, and impressively, they can do so for extended periods. Even the Amazon River or the Mississippi River have its share of roaming bull sharks. Incredibly, meaning that this shark is able to share its space with such tropical freshwater icons as anacondas and piranhas. It's a unique and rare habitat choice for a shark that sets them apart from many of their oceanic brethren, and it does this with an incredible quirk of urinary manipulation. Most sharks control their osmolarity by redirecting urea into their tissues. This essentially prevents the water in their bodies from being sucked out of their gills into the salty brine of the ocean, but it also prevents them from entering fresh water, where the opposite would happen. The salty tissues in the shark would draw in copious amounts of water to their cells, swelling and damaging them. Bull sharks have much more control over this system than other species, and when entering relatively fresher water, they urinate in copious amounts. This lowers their internal salinity, bringing them into balance with the fresher water of the river. When leaving, they reverse this process to return to the ocean. This is an incredibly adaptive breeding strategy, as most of the bull shark's predators cannot follow it upstream to feed on its young. If there are no estuaries around, they find their nurseries in the relative safety of protective mangrove forests. Generally speaking, however, they are mostly found in saltwater. They inhabit coastal regions worldwide from countries such as the United States, Brazil, Australia, Madagascar, and many more. There are a number of animals ready to feast on a bull shark if given the chance. The ocean is a brutal landscape with relatively few plants compared with terrestrial environments. Here, almost every animal is going to feed on something smaller. This means there's always a bigger fish, and even a fearsome predator such as the bull shark has to watch its back. Any toothed shark larger than the bull shark will be happy to eat one, and this includes great white sharks or tiger sharks. Orcas are also known to hunt bull sharks. Juveniles are especially vulnerable to predation from larger predators. While the bull shark has been a dominant species of coastal waters for millions of years, its current conservation status suggests a different future. This species is now categorized as vulnerable on the IUCN Red List. Its status is almost exclusively a result of human activities. Overfishing poses a considerable threat, with estimates suggesting up to 100 million sharks, including bull sharks, are killed annually. Whether it's intentional targeting for their fins, meat, and liver oil, or much more commonly, as bycatch of the global fishing industry, these numbers are alarming. Habitat degradation further exacerbates their situation. Coastal development, pollution, and dredging directly impact the crucial nursery grounds for young sharks, with reports indicating a decline of over 70% in overall shark populations in recent decades. The bull shark's might is now overshadowed by its vulnerability. This underlines the urgent need for global conservation efforts to safeguard these magnificent creatures, but public sympathy for the species can be hard to muster. There are hundreds of species of shark, and only a tiny fraction of these have ever harmed humans. However, this statistic isn't very comforting when it comes to the bull shark. One of the big three responsible for human injuries and deaths from attacks, along with tiger and great white sharks. Bull sharks are particularly unique because of their proclivity to swim in shallow coastal waters and even venture into freshwater systems like rivers. This behavior means that they frequently share spaces with fishermen and swimmers, and in murky water, where they're more likely to bite first, ask questions later. Some of the most notable human encounters with bull sharks have occurred in rivers, far from the ocean, like the infamous shark attacks in the Matawan Creek in New Jersey back in 1916. In a span of just under 2 weeks, 5 people fell victim to bull shark attacks, and only one survived. The attacks in fresh water led to urban legends of sharks inhabiting the Great Lakes. In the ocean, however, bull sharks have been filmed ramming a fishing kayak, apparently in a frenzied attempt to prey on the fisherman's catch. Now, while these statistics and stories can be unnerving, it's crucial to put them in perspective. Shark attacks, though widely publicized, are rare. In fact, more people are injured each year by domestic animals, or even mundane activities like tripping, than by sharks. However, that doesn't mean you should be careless around them, because they are wild and powerful animals after all. So, the bull shark, a masterpiece of evolution and adaptability, truly embodies a wonder of the marine world. This ancient and unique predator has adaptations not seen in any other species, and as such, plays an equally unique role in its ecosystems. But, sadly, these are a threatened species and need all the help they can get. As we continue our journey through nature, let's take a leaf from the bull shark's book and learn to adapt, thrive, and most importantly, live in harmony with the world around us. If you liked this video, please subscribe for the next one, and don't forget to click the like button to keep our channel going.